Arabs are the most maligned group in the history of Hollywood. They're portrayed basically as subhumans, untermenschen, a term used by Nazis to vilify gypsies and Jews. These images have been with us for more than a century. For 30 years, I've looked at how we, particularly when I say we, image makers, have projected Arabs on silver screens. In my latest book, Real Bad Arabs, How Hollywood Vilifies a People, I looked at more than 1,000 films. Films ranging from the earliest, most obscure days of Hollywood to today's biggest blockbuster. And what I tried to do is to make visible what too many of us seem not to see. A dangerously consistent pattern of hateful Arab stereotypes. Stereotypes that rob an entire people of their humanity. All aspects of our culture project the Arab as villain. That is a given. There is no deviation. We have taken a few structured images and repeated them over and over again.
You are hostages of the Holy Freedom Party.
Whether one lives in Paducah, Kentucky or Wood River, Illinois, we know basically the same thing.
Listen to the sound,
Jesus,
of our God.
We know the mythology. The mythology, namely Hollywood's images of Arabs. Yesteryear's Arab land is today's Arab land. The Arab is one-dimensional caricature, cartoon cutouts used by filmmakers as stock villains and as comic relief. And so over and over we see Arabs in movies portrayed as buffoons, their only purpose being to deliver cheap laughs. You see this in the Joey Heatherton film, The Happy Hooker Goes to Washington.
Every night I was forced to perform unspeakable acts with circumcised dogs.
Oh, dogs are better than sheep. They're cleaner, I know, I've tried both.
The stereotype has become so widespread that it's become invisible to people. And the reason being is that we've all grown up with these images. Just look at television. We now have TV shows telling us that, in addition to the Arab terrorists over there, American Arabs over here are also terrorists. Then there's Showtime's Sleeper Cell. Here a sinister network of Islamic groups operates on American street corners. Any homeless man could be part of this network. Even Western-looking Arabs are part of this anti-American conspiracy.
We're at war with America, period. And we're going to win that war by convincing enough Americans through the spread of fear, insecurity, and terror to change their ways. And the best way to teach that lesson is by attacking them where they live, work, and play.
And this paranoia runs deep. So, when innocent Arabs are killed, when they're bombed, maimed, wounded, when they're tortured in places like Abu Ghraib, is it really any surprise that we don't feel any compassion? Or worse, make light of it?
This is no different than what happens at the Skull and Bones initiation, and we're going to ruin people's lives over it, and we're going to hamper our military effort. You ever heard of emotional release? You ever heard of need to blow some steam off?
Well, yeah, sort of like hazing, a fraternity prank, sort of like that kind of fun. But the point is, everybody's been saying that this came from...
We don't care about that. We've been preconditioned to think that those innocent civilians, clones of Al-Qaeda and Saddam Hussein, are one and the same, and do not merit our sympathy, our understanding. And that's very dangerous.
This is Zion!